Hi and welcome back to my channel. My name is Lakme Shweton. Ladies and gentlemen, these are most unusual times. I don't know what's going on in your part of the world exactly, but here in Nigeria, because of the great disease whose name we must not mention, the government has implemented stay-at-home orders for certain parts of the country, and it's been tough. The stay-at-home order has been difficult for people for many different reasons, from medical to financial. But being your friendly neighborhood relationship coach, today I'm going to be talking about how the stay-at-home order affects romantic relationships. By the way, I did a video earlier on how to handle quarantine or isolation if you are single. So if you're interested in that, go watch the video. Hopefully I'll remember to link the video in the description box below, but go and check it out. It's on my YouTube channel. So my tips today will be useful for anybody anywhere in the world who is in a relationship or is stuck at home with their partner because of stay-at-home orders or because of quarantine and isolation. Today, I'm going to be sharing love tips for couples in lockdown. No matter how much you and your partner may be in love, it's difficult not to get on each other's nerves if you are together all day, every day. So, in order to prevent you from breaking your man's head in frustration, today I'm going to be giving you tips on how to get through the lockdown situation without drama. My first tip for couples in lockdown is to see this enforced time together as a blessing. Pre-isolation or pre-quarantine, many couples barely saw each other. In fact, that's one of the reasons why many couples fight. One person always seems to be at work or with friends or something and doesn't seem to have time for the other partner or the children, and so the couple fights. So, if you've ever berated your partner for not spending enough time with you, now you're getting your wish. Of course, it's not happening in the way that you probably wanted it to happen, but when the universe answers our prayers, it doesn't always do that in the way we expect. Still, even if you are desperately in love with your partner, being together so much means that you'll start to notice little things about your partner that irritates you. Who knew that the way somebody breathed could be annoying? What you need to do at this kind of point is to remember that if you're finding your partner irritating or little things that they are doing is annoying you, realize that it's very likely that your partner is feeling the same way about you as well, but they may not be showing it. They may not be acting up. Be grateful for that. Also, remind yourself of all the things you love about your partner. Fine, they may not arrange clothes in the specific manner in which you like it, but maybe they entertain your kids for hours on end so that you'll have a break. Always focus on the good. My second tip for couples in lockdown is to give each other space. Love cannot blossom in a choked environment. You and your partner are forced to be indoors, but that doesn't mean that you have to be together 24/7. The two of you need to give each other space. If you live in a small flat, this is the time to get creative. Go into another room, even if it's the kitchen or the bathroom or the toilet. It will shock you how refreshed you can feel just spending a few minutes alone, even if it's in the loo. If you have a balcony you can chill on, go and make use of it. And if you have a backyard, you're lucky, get out there and take a walk. I read somewhere that there was a man during this lockdown period, somewhere in the world, and he ran an entire marathon, all 42 kilometers of it, in his 6 meter long garden. That's incredible. I can't imagine myself doing anything like that, but that's the kind of creativity that comes out with this kind of period. Give each other space, and you and your partner may still be on talking terms by the time this lockdown is over. My third tip for couples in lockdown is to relax your rules for yourself, your partner, and your children if you have any. Maybe normally clothes are washed on Saturdays, toys are put away immediately after being played with, and no one comes to the living room unless fully dressed. But these are unusual times. Unfortunately, nobody is going to come and inspect your home to see if you're following your own self-imposed rules. Give yourself and everyone else a break. Everyone is feeling tense right now. Even little children know that there's something wrong. So let things slide a little. You and everyone in your home will feel a little better as a result. Another tip I have for you is that while you may be feeling trapped and you feel like the walls are closing in on you, one of the most useful things you can do right now is to visualize a future in which you are happy and all the things you'll be able to do once the stay-at-home order is lifted. In the meantime, if you need a little extra help with your relationship, contact me for coaching so that you can thrive during these trying times. To see my coaching rates, please go to www.billy.com/lakpe love coach. For more love and relationship content that you won't find here on my channel, listen to my podcast. Subscribe and listen to my podcast for free by going to www.billy.com/lakpe's podcast. If you want regular tips from me on how to find the right person for you if you're single and how to be happy even if you have no one else in your life, or how to improve your relationship, then follow me on Instagram. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up below, share with your friends, and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on the red subscribe button you'll see down below, or by clicking on my picture that you'll see somewhere on the screen. After you subscribe, remember to click on the bell that you see there so that you'll be notified as soon as a new video of mine comes out. I wish you love and strength.